Well, good evening, everyone. Thank you so much for coming. My name is Jonathan Borman. I'm pastor here at this church, and it's my pleasure to introduce to you the chorus of Wisconsin Lutheran Seminary. Wisconsin Lutheran Seminary is the place where we train all of the pastors in our church body. I'm a proud graduate. I also was in the chorus back in the day. Our vicar, Ethan Schultz, is studying at Wisconsin Lutheran Seminary tonight, and you're going to see a whole bunch of future pastors in our synod tonight. Please give them a warm welcome and enjoy the concert tonight.
Thank you. brothers and sisters. It is truly our joy and privilege to be with you here to keep unpacking the joy of Jesus' Easter resurrection this Easter week as we present our program, Christ is the World's Light, a walk through the life of Jesus from Bethlehem to eternity, where one day we will see him. You will be invited several times to join in the singing, and we thank you again for being here.
Heaven from earth, thou comest in thy.
this next piece by Keith and Christine Getty, we'd kindly ask you to join with the type in bold type.
Lord, from the depths I call. Please stand for the reading of the Gospel. The Gospel according to St. Matthew, chapter 9. Jesus went through all the towns and villages, teaching in their synagogues, proclaiming the good news of the kingdom and healing every disease and sickness. When he saw the crowds, he had compassion on them because they were harassed and helpless, like sheep without a shepherd. Then he said to his disciples, "The harvest is plentiful, but the workers are few. Ask the Lord of the harvest, therefore, to send out workers into his harvest field." The Gospel of our Lord. Please be seated. When Jesus looked out at that crowd of people, what did he see? Did he see a gathering of people who had life figured out, who knew exactly what they were doing? No. He saw them for what they truly are: sheep without a shepherd. He saw them as people who were wandering about in the darkness of this sin-stained world with not a thought going to the real problem at the center of them all: their own spiritual depravity as sinners, weighed down by the burden of their own imperfection and guilt. And it was every single one of them. A world wandering about in the darkness with nothing to guide them, sheep without a shepherd. When we think about the world that we live in today, can we say that much has changed? Can we say that people are any less concerned about their physical problems? Can we say that people have a strong grasp on the problem of sin and the punishment that it poses? Or would we say that most people think they're following some kind of guiding light in life, something that gives them a sense of direction or something that gives them purpose, but in the end, it's inevitably just an empty, unsatisfying, unfulfilled endeavor, that it's less of a guiding light and it's really just more darkness in disguise? If that's true of the world, when we look out there, do we see them only as people living life for the wrong reasons? Or do we see them as they truly are? Sheep without a shepherd. And then, what happens when we look in the mirror? You and I both know that sometimes we can start to wander off and get lost. And yeah, maybe it happens more often than we'd like to admit. It happens when life's distractions start to take first priority. And it gets even worse when we start to look for solutions to life's problems in places other than God's word. That's when we can start to wander off and get lost. And yes, maybe it happens more often than we'd like to admit. But you know what? Our good shepherd comes and finds us every time. Because just as he looked at the people back then, so he looks at us today and every day. Jesus looks at you and me, and he loves us. He loves us enough to have taken our place, to be the sacrificial lamb on the altar of the cross. He loves us enough to take on every single one of our shameful acts and our disgusting deeds, every single one of our sins, every single one of the things that makes us feel guilty and gross and disgusting. Everything we've ever done wrong. He loves us enough to die the death that we've deserved, to endure the hell that we've earned. Why?
Because when Jesus looks at us, he loves us. Brothers and sisters, when Jesus looks at the rest of the world, he looks at them in the exact same way. Billions of lost people wandering about in the darkness with nothing to guide them, people who don't know their shepherd. And he loves them. And the humbling part is, we're the ones whom God has chosen to share the light of that wonderful good news message. God has commissioned his church to go out and tell the people of the world that Jesus died for them so that they could live with him. But that's just it, isn't it? People of the world. It's a lot of people to talk to. The harvest is plentiful. So what do we do? Ask the Lord of the harvest to send out workers. Include pastors in your prayers. Pray that more people would consider entering the public ministry of the gospel. Encourage the young men in your life to think about whether or not they have the gifts and the desire to be under shepherds for the good shepherd. At Wisconsin Lutheran Seminary, written just above the doors to the chapel, is a daily reminder for each of the men who were just standing in front of you. Ke ruxete ta euangelion. It's Greek. It means, preach the gospel. Tell about Jesus and his love. Proclaim him as the light in this sin-darkened world. Be workers in the harvest field of God. We train for that, and we do that so that when we look out at the world, we don't just see a group of people living life for the wrong reasons. No, we look at them so we can see them as they truly are. Sheep without a shepherd. We train for this, and we do this so that when we look at them, we can love them as he first loved us. Brothers and sisters, as Christians, as fellow members of God's flock, you can too. So, let's get to work. God grant it. Amen. We neglected to pass out the programs at the start of the concert, so you're getting some now. Just give us a second to pass these out. Thank you for your patience.
Because your seminary, Wisconsin Lutheran Seminary, is a classy organization, we always print a concert program, and we even some of the times take them off the bus. So, thank you. I apologize. That last piece, which is so lovely, none of you were singing, and I thought, what's wrong? Well, no. If you go with me, I'm sorry, to page one, I do apologize. We began with a Nigerian Christmas carol. Basically, Christ is born in Bethlehem for you. And then I think the only other one you would have struggled with is the Latin, which is Christ was crucified under Pontius Pilate, suffered, and was buried. A direct quote from the creed that we speak as Lutheran Christians every weekend. With that, will you turn with me now, please, to page four, and I will ask you immediately to ignore the singing directions at the top of the page. The choir will sing stanza three. You sing everything else. We'll keep it easy.
Prepared, who there Sustained.
Here in just a moment, we are going to be passing the plates for a free will offering to support the ministry of the choir. Also, after the service, you'll have a chance. There's some blue bins in the back to support the choir with a free will offering. And following the service, you can purchase some CDs as well.
Made new. is all creation groaning.
It is.
Is a new creation coming.
It is.
Is the glory of the Lord to be the light within our midst.
It is.
Is it good that we remind ourselves of this?
It is.
Is anyone worthy? Is anyone whole? Is anyone able to break the seal and open the scroll? The Lion of Judah, is he worthy? Is he worthy of all blessing and honor and glory? Is he worthy of this? He is. Does the Father truly love us?
He does.
Does the Spirit move among us?
He does.
And does Jesus, our Messiah, hold forever those he loves?
He does.
Does our God intend to dwell again with us?
He does. Is anyone worthy? Is anyone whole?
Go ahead and grab your seats. I want to just do a thank you, obviously, a thank you to all of you for making this trip. Professor Christie, thank you for coming to our church. I'm going to do something that's kind of embarrassing, but I think it's kind of cool. One of our own, Kyla, has a brother in the chorus. He was playing sax down here, and he's up there. Yeah. Joshua Schrader. And just to help you think about, these are future pastors, and maybe to help you think about this, this was a suggestion I got from Professor Christie. I thought it was a good one. How many of you, we got to do this Wisconsin Lutheran Seminary style, so we're going to start with the seniors. How many of you are seniors and are up for a call coming up this May? Yeah. 30-year students are vicars. We got one of those here. Yeah. Second year students are called middlers. How many middlers we got? All right, there's our middlers. They're getting calls coming up here in May too to be vicars. There you go. And first year students are juniors. How many juniors we got? All right. Please do, if you are hosting some of these young men, let's have you meet kind of like right here, just kind of mosey up here, and we'll get you connected to the to your right people. So if you're hosting or one of those guys who's staying with the host, mosey on right over here, and we'll get you connected up. If you didn't have a chance to give to the free will offering, there's blue baskets, blue little buckets on the right and left as you exit the sanctuary this evening. And there's also CDs that you can purchase in the Welcome Center. Thank you all for being here tonight.